Hello. Here's the second video that I said I'd do about the poems of Abu Nuwas. I'll read. I mean, these are the Finnish translations of the Arabic original, but I'll read them in Finnish and then I'll translate them into English so that you could have a sense of what are the building blocks of Finnish sentences. Anyway, here's a poem called Tuulet kohtaavat. Minä rakastan pohjatuulta, sillä sanotaan, että se tulee rakkaani luota. Niin kai hänkin rakastaa etelätuulta, kun se huokuu häntä vastaan. Lyhyt riemo, pitkä murhe, vain tuulet kohtaavat kantaen viestiä sydämestä. So anyway, tuulet kohtaavat. Tuuli is wind. Tuulet is the plural winds. Kohtaavat. Kohdata is to meet. So tuulet kohtaavat is the meeting of the winds. Or the winds meet in this, but I prefer the title meeting of the winds. But anyway, it's literally the winds meet. Minä rakastan pohjatuulta. Minä rakastan is I love. Pohja in this instance, pohjoinen is north. So I'm assuming that it's like a poetical way of saying northerly wind. So pohjatuuli, northerly wind. I love the northerly wind. The next sentence, sillä sanotaan. It means because it is said. Sillä, it's a bit like the Finnish word. Well, it's sort of a multi-purpose word. It's the kind of pronoun that can be made useful in several different ways. But anyway, in this particular instance, sillä sanotaan. The sillä means sillä is sillä, with umlaut. It means because, or maybe a better translation would be for it is said, because it's somewhat archaic, like it's ever so slightly archaic way of saying, for it is said, and then sanotaan it is said. Sanoa is to say, minä sanon, I say, sinä sanot, you say, hän sanoo, he says, me sanomme, we say, te sanotte, you say, he sanovat, they say. So sanotaan is, it is said, it's the passive. Sillä sanotaan, for it is said, että se tulee rakkaani luota. Että means ETTA with umlaut. It means that. For it is said that se tulee, it arrives, rakkaani luota, from my love. To come or to arrive is tulla, but then minä tulen, sinä tulet, hän tulee, or in this case se tulee, it is coming, it arrives. Rakkaani, my beloved, and luota, from my beloved. So luota in this, jonkun luota. From somebody, so minun luota, from where I am, sinun luota, from where you are, hänen luota, from where she is, in this case. So, että se tulee rakkainen luota, sillä sanotaan, että se tulee rakkainen luota, for it is said that it comes from my beloved's place, for instance, or from where my beloved is. So anyway, the next paragraph. Niin kai hänkin rakastaa etelätuulta. Niin kai. In this case, niin kai hänkin rakastaa etelätuulta. It would be translated as so too, I imagine. It would be translated as something like, so too do I imagine she loves the southerly wind. So etelätuulta is the southerly wind. Rakastaa, she loves. Hänkin, hän is she in this instance, and then hänkin is she too. A bit like in the last poem, there was the enkä vallan vähän. The word en would be the word a is no, but then when you add the k with umlaut, the no takes a special significance. And here to the word keen, it changes the word hän into she too. Hän keen, she too. And then the niin kai, sorry, niin. Niin kai. So anyway, niin kai. Those are difficult words to translate. Niin basically means so. So no niin would mean okay then in Finnish. So those are difficult words to pronounce, but anyway, niin means so, and then kai in this means I guess. So kai is sort of making the sentence it's as if it's functioning like a conditional clause. So, niin kai hänkin rakastaa. I guess so too goes her love for the southerly wind. So, yeah, that's a somewhat strange sentence, but, you know, that's how it's translated, more or less. And then, kun se huokuu häntä vastaan, kun is when, se is it, so kun se, when it, huokuu häntä vastaan, häntä vastaan is against her, minua vastaan would be against me, sinua vastaan would be against you, häntä vastaan against her, and then huokuu häntä vastaan, I don't know how to translate huoku. It's more like when it's breathing against her, when it's rolling against her. It's huoku is a strange verb. It's basically describing what the wind does. So what the wind does is the wind huokuu. Let's say that it's rolling its breaths towards her. So that's the third sentence. Lyhyt riemu, brief joy. Lyhyt is short, or in this case brief, and then riemu is joy. Pitkä murhe. Pitkä is tall. Murhe is grief, but in this case, pitkä murhe is, lyhyt riemu, short joy, pitkä murhe, long agony. So, pitkä murhe, long agony. Vain tuulet kohtaavat. Vain in this case means only. Tuulet, the winds, kohtaavat meet. Only the winds may meet to balance out the line. Only the winds may meet. Kanten viestiä sydämestä. Carrying messages from our hearts. Carrying messages. Carrying the messages of hearts, I suppose you translate. So kantaa is to carry, viesti, message, sydän, heart, and then viestiä sydämestä, message from the heart. So that was the second poem. Now this is kind of strange. How did I manage explaining, like, these poems are the same length? How did I explain the other poem 40 minutes and this only 12 minutes? Well, I don't know, but I don't know if I should read one more. I don't know if I should read one more. I mean, since it's time, I'll read one more. Palauta sieluni. Sinä suutuit, kun katsoin sinuun. Minä en suuttunut, vaikka veit sieluni. Sinä rankaiset minua, pidät minua loitolla. Etkö pelkää Jumalan kostoa, jos rukoilen sinua vastaan? Palauta sieluni ruumiiseeni. Ole kanssani, jotta eläisin jälleen. Rakkauden orja, valittava. Voiko ruumis elää ilman sielua? Muuta en pyydä, en vaadi kuin omani takaisin. Sinä tapaat minut vielä joskus katseellasi, silmilläsi, sinä vieton gasellini. So anyway, palauta sieluni. Please return my soul. So palauta is, it's the imperative form. Imperative is like an order, return. So there isn't any I return, you return, he returns, because it's the imperative. It's it's a specific form. So palauta, return, sieluni. Sielu is soul, and sieluni is my soul. Return my soul. So anyway, the first paragraph, sinä suutuit, you became angry. Suuttua is to become angry. Minä suutun, sinä suutut, hän suuttuu, me suutumme, te suututte, he suuttuvat. So sinä suutuit, It's the past tense of it's the what we call the imperfect tense. So sinä suutuit, you got mad or you became angry. Kun katsoin sinuun, kun katsoin sinun means as I looked at you. So, as I looked at you became angry. Katsoin sinuun. Katso is to look. And then sinä turns into sinuun. It's the past position of at you. As I looked at you became angry. Minä en suuttunut. I did not become angry. Vaikka veit sieloni, even though you stole my soul. The poet is a magnanimous man. Sinä rankaiset minua. You punish me. Rankaista is to punish. So, minä rankaisen, I punish, sinä rankaiset, you punish. And then minua, minä is me, but minua, it's basically, well, it's the postposition form of that instance. So anyway, pidät minua loitolla. Pitää loitolla means you keep me apart from you or you keep me away from you. So pitää loitolla, to keep away. Pidät minua loitolla, you keep me away from you. Etkö pelkää Jumalan kostoa? Do you not fear the wrath of God? Jos rukoilen sinua vastaan, if I pray against you. So the magnanimity of the poet is seeing a slight shadow cast on its doubtlessly boundless realm. So anyway, etkö pelkää Jumalan kostoa? Do you not fear the wrath of God? Jumala is God. Kosto is, well, it's basically vengeance, but the wrath is sort of more, King James-ish. But anyway, etkö pelkää? Do you not fear? So pelätä, PEL, evitumlat, is to fear. And then pelkää is the third person, hän pelkää. Wait. Wait. So anyway, sorry, let me take it back a while. So anyway, the kind of structure of etkö pelkää, if you make it a question, do I not fear? Enkö minä pelkää? Do you not fear? Etkö sinä pelkää? Does he not fear? Eikö hän pelkää? Do we not fear? Emmekö me pelkää? Do you not fear? Ettekö te pelkää? Do they not fear? Eivätkö he pelkää? So the word pelkää is always in. So you don't conjugate the word pelkää in this instance. So because you keep changing the enkö etkö, eikö, emmekö, ettekö, eivätkö. Because you keep changing those, the word pelkää remains with that tense. So, etkö is do you not. Se etkö with umlaut, etkö. It's the do you not. Do you not in Finnish is etkö. So etkö pelkää, do you not fear. And then jos rukoilen sinua vastaan. Jos is if. Rukoilen, I pray, sinua. Sinua vastaan, against you. So the next sentence. Palauta sieluni ruumiiseeni. Palauta sieluni, return my soul, ruumiiseeni, to my body. So ruumis is body. And ruumiiseeni, basically into my body. So, ole kanssani, be with me. Olla kanssa, to be with somebody. So, ole kanssani, be with me. Jotta eläisin jälleen, so I could live again. Rakkauden ori, slave of love, valittava, one who laments. Voiko ruumis elää ilman sielua? Can a body live without a soul? Muuta en pyydä, en vaadi kun omani takaisin. Muuta en pyydä, I ask for nothing else. En vaadi kun omani takaisin. All I demand is what is mine. Vaatia, to demand. En vaadi, I do not demand. Muuta kuin, anything beyond. Omani takaisin, what is mine back. You know, what is mine returned. Takaisin is back. Sinä tapat minut vielä joskus katseellasi, silmälläsi. Those eyes of yours will kill me one day. Sinä vieton gazelleni, you innocent gazelle. Or gazellini, my gazelle, my innocent gazelle. So that's the, you know, poet's, pet epithet for the person who so causes him sleepless nights. So, those were some of the poems of Abu Nuwas translated into Finnish. I'd have some more volumes of poetry. I don't feel like reading any more of Abu Nuwas. But anyway, I could do a couple of more videos about us just looking to what the Finnish sentences are like and what are their building blocks. I think I'll switch to a different poet. Let's see what I have out from the library. So I'll stop this video and I think I'll do maybe one more. So, thanks for watching this. Hopefully you learned something and, hope I'll see you at the next video as well, but anyway, bye for now.